Chevys cost less at Jack Burford Chevrolet in Richmond. Save on new Silverado 1500, 2500 heavy-duty, and 3500 heavy-duty trucks. Shop online at jackburford.com. Jack Burford Chevrolet, where Chevys cost less.
From the studios of WBONTV.com, I'm Marissa Hempel, and this is your Thursday afternoon news brief. A threat made on social media against Lincoln County High School resulted in quick responses from local police. A photo that was identified as a threat had been sent to the school earlier this week, showing a student holding a weapon. The student was identified right away, and within hours, the situation was handled by school authorities. School officials say that because of a community member that promptly reported the threat, even after school hours, the situation was de-escalated and there was no need to cause alarm to parents or students. Police have filed charges, and the student has reportedly faced disciplinary action. An apartment building in Irving caught fire for the fourth time this year, this morning. According to the fire department, they arrived just after 1 a.m. at the location where the flames were heavy on the second floor of the Estill County home. The inferno was pushing through the roof, but they were able to contain the blaze. An investigation is pending. A father and son from Berea who share the same name also shared the same courtroom recently and were sentenced for sex crimes side by side. Alvin D. Bradley and his son Alvin H. Bradley were both accused of sexually abusing victims under the age of 12. The elder Bradley was accused of years-long abuse for a victim as well, beginning when they were only 4 years of age, in both Iowa and Kentucky. Both men were denied probation by the judge. Charges for a Winchester man who was accused of shooting his girlfriend have been reduced, according to local news reports. Clarence Robbie Reynolds is accused of shooting Megan Griffin, who took a gunshot wound to her leg. Reynolds then apparently went on the run and was not found by police for days. Police report the two were in a relationship prior to the alleged assault. Reynolds was located and charged with first-degree assault and tampering with physical evidence. However, the judge recently lowered the charge to second-degree assault and lowered the bail for Reynolds, who is still lodged in the Clark County Detention Center. And tonight at the Paddy Wagon Pub in Richmond, Mason Tackett, the man who has gone viral after getting his cheese grater stolen in Floyd County, will be visiting. The bar will be charging a $5 cover and there will be a cookout on the patio. Tackett will no doubt be giving an uncensored, dramatic retelling of the comical burglary. For more stories such as these, be sure to visit Richmond's very own WBONTV.com. I'm Marissa Hempel.